Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with the subject artificial intelligence. The next topic in the subject is the resolution in first order logic. Okay, now let's see what's the resolution in first order logic. A resolution is a theorem proving technique that proves by contradiction. The first thing that you have to remember that if you want to solve a resolution problem, you have to proof contradiction. Whenever the contradiction is success, then the solution is resoluted. Okay, so a resolution theorem is a proving technique, theorem proving technique that proves by contradiction. It is used if there are various statements are given and we need to prove a conclusion from of those statements. Let's take there are so many statements in the problem. Okay, so with the help of those statements we have to prove, we have to get a conclusion. Okay, so some different questions will be arised. So by seeing the different questions and you'll get different answers. In the different answers you need to get one conclusion in that. So in that cases we will use this resolution concept in the artificial intelligence. Okay, so the resolution is used if there are various statements are given and we need to prove a conclusion of those statements. And unification is a key concept in proofs by resolution. So with the help of this unification, we are going to prove the resolution. So unification can be solved by using the substitution method. So if you don't know about the unification, just see my video, whatever I explained previously. Okay, if you understand the unification, then only you can understand this resolution. So first see the video of unification and later come to this resolution. Then you will clearly understood what is this resolution topic is. Resolution is a single inference rules which can efficiently operate on conjective normal forms or closed forms. Okay, so here we are resolution can be solved and it can efficiently operated on CNF, that is a conjective normal forms. So closes is the distinction of literals is called clause, whereas conjective normal form is a sentence represented as a conjunction of clauses is said to be CNF. So first thing is, whatever the first order logic is there, that first order logic has to be converted into this conjunction normal form. Then only you can prove by resolution. Means with the help of the conjunctive normal form statements, you can prove by resolution whatever the statements they are given. Means we can find the various statements that are given and we need to prove a conclusion of those statements. Okay, so now let's see the steps for resolution. These are the important. So based on these steps we are going to solve the problem one by one. So first is conversion of facts into first order logic. Whatever the statements, the series of statements they are given, that statement has to be first converted into first order logic. You know the first order logic. The first order logic consisting of the facts and it will be uses some connectivities. Okay, so I already explained about the first order logic. It has the statements like objects, connectivities, functions, relationships, everything will be there, the statement. So after converting the first order logic, that statements, again, you have to convert it into CNF. First, convert the facts into first order logic. Next, convert the first order logic into conjunctive normal forms. After whatever the conjunctive normal forms you are getting, negate the statement which needed to be proved by contradiction. So you have to negate the statement, whatever the statement you are thinking that has to be proved. Just take that statement, negate. Okay, you just take the contradiction of that statement and draw the resolution graph. So these are the four steps for the resolution. What are these? First, convert the given facts into first order logic. After that, the first order logic is converted into CNF, okay, conjunctive normal forms. After that, you have to, whatever the statement that you get, that statement you need to be negate and you have to prove that by contradiction. And we have to draw the resolution graph with the help of unification, means by substitution method. So let's see some example. So here in this video, I'll explain with some example. Suppose if you didn't understand these examples, don't worry. And I'll explain one more example in the next video with simple concept. Okay, here I am taking a big problem by applying these rules, these steps to solve the resolution. So here the example is, I'm having a series of steps. In these statements, I need to find the conclusion by using the resolution. Okay. So here are the steps. So John likes all kind of food. Okay. John is a person. He likes all kind of food. So whenever you are seeing this, it is nothing but you have to use the universal quantifiers. Okay. So means I have to convert these statements into FOL. FOL is consisting of the quantifiers, the universal and existential quantifiers. With the help of those quantifiers, you have to represent the statements. So these are all the facts. John likes all kind of food. Apple and vegetables are food. Anything anyone eats and not killed is food. Anil eats peanut and still alive. And Harry eats everything that Anil eats. And prove by resolution that John likes peanut. So these are the steps, whatever the statements they are given. So we have to prove John likes peanut. So in the third step, what I have to take? I have to take the negate the statement which need to be proved. Means John does not like the peanut, I have to take to prove that contradiction. But first, whatever the steps they are given, convert these steps into first order logic. How? So first statement is John likes all kind of food. That means, let's take for all x, the food x likes, that is, you have to represent this statement, John likes all kind of food. John likes food, that is, all kind of food. For all x, food. So, universal quantifier is represented with the implies. It can be work on implies. So, for all x, food of x, John likes that food. So, the first statement is over. The second statement. Apple and vegetables are food. Means here apple is a food and vegetable is also a food. So that you can represent it as in the first order logic. Food, apple is a food and vegetable is a food. Okay, second statement is over. Now third statement I have to represent it in first order logic. Anything anyone eats and not killed is food. Anything anyone eats and not killed is food. So that is here the for all x, for all y, eats x comma y and not killed x, that is the food is not food is, it's not killed. Here they are saying that not killed is food. So not killed implies food of y. So this statement I have represented in the first order logic. Next one, Anil eats peanuts and still alive. So this is the fourth statement I have to convert into first order logic. Anil eats peanuts and still alive. So Anil eats peanut and he is still alive. Anil eats peanut and he is still alive. Okay. Next statement. Harry eats everything that Anil eats. So Harry eats everything that Anil eats. So see here. For all x. Okay. Anil eats X and Harry also eats that X because Harry eats everything that Anil eats. So Harry and Anil both will eat the same. Whatever the Harry eats, everything that Anil also eats. So that's why Anil eats X means the Harry also eats X for all X. Okay, is it clear? So I had taken that, I had to prove by resolution that John likes peanuts. So further, I had to take some added predicates here. That is, if suppose not killed means, obviously it is alive. So alive means not killed. So both are the same. I have taken the added these predicates. Next, John likes peanut. John likes peanut. So I represented in the predicate form. So this is a step one. Now coming to the step two. So what is the step two? Whatever the first order logic that I converted, that I have to convert it into conjective normal form CNF. That is a step two. Why I'm converting into CNF? Because CNF makes easier for resolution proofs. So for that sake, we are converting the FOL into CNF. So how you're going to convert the given FOL into CNF? There are series of steps you have to be followed. There are total five steps here, six steps that need to, how it is going to be converted into CNF. The first thing is, eliminate all implications. So wherever the implication symbol is there, that you have to eliminate and rewrite. Then you'll get it out. How I can rewrite the implication? Suppose A implies B is there. So I can eliminate these A implies B by writing negate A or B. So this both are the same. Okay, that means A imply B is equal to negate A or B. So here the implication is eliminated or not. Okay, so this is the formula. If you want to, wherever the imply symbol is there, this imply symbol has to be eliminated by rewriting it as negate A or B. So let's see, wherever the negation imply symbol is there, that I need to be eliminated. So the first, in the first, what is this? Food of X implies likes John of X. So I want to eliminate this. This is, let's take this is A and this is B. A implies B. So I have to write it as negate A or B. Okay, I have to write this as negate A or B. So how I can write? Here A is food of X. So in place of A, write food of X. Or in place of B, write likes John, comma X. Like that. Okay, put negation here. So I just put negation here. Negation food of X or likes John, comma X. So in the same way, so in the second step, there is no implies. There is no implies. So write as it is. In the third step, there is an implies. There is an implies. Let's take this is A and implies B. A implies B. Apply the formula. Negate A or B. So you have to represent this statement in the form like this. Negate A or B. So whatever the statements I have written, just eliminate all implications and write in this form. So then here observe, there is no implication here. Only the negations will be there. So I eliminated the implied symbols and rewrite with this formula. That's the first step. In the second step, that is the first thing. And the second thing to convert the first order logic into conjective normal form is move the negation inwards and rewrite. So whatever the negation that is there, so here I apply, I have to move that negation inwards. That means, so here suppose negation is there, here the brackets is there. I want to move that negation into inside. Negate eats x comma y, and here end becomes or. Whenever the negate application is there, end becomes or. And this negate negate will be cancelled and it becomes killed x, like that. Okay, so that is the second step, move negation inwards and rewrite. So I rewrite all the statement by moving the negation inwards. Next, third step. In this third, after that I have eliminated the implications, I have inverts the negation. Now rename the variables or standardization variables. So to make somewhat difference without confusion, you just rename the variables. So wherever the x y is there, just rename all the variables with y, z, z, k, whatever it may be. Okay, so to avoid the confusion. And the fourth one is eliminate existential instantiation or quantifier by elimination. But here in our problem, there is no existential quantifiers because we all use the universal quantifiers only. So here, whatever the steps that are there, they are remains as it is. Now, drop the universal quantifiers. Now, whatever the universal quantifiers are there, I want to drop it. So, there is no change will come if you drop the universal quantifiers. So, you just drop all the universal quantifiers, whatever it is appeared in the problem. Okay, and rewrite the statements like this. Just write. Just remove the universal quantifiers and write. Okay, so after dropping that, I have to distribute the conjunction, but here there will not be any change. So these are the steps for converting only for the FOL into conjunctive normal form. So what I done, I eliminated the implications. So after that, what I have done, after eliminating the implications, I just move the negation inwards and rewrite. After that, I rename the variables or standardize the variables. So after that, what I have taken, eliminate the existential quantifiers if present and drop the universal quantifiers, and you'll get some statements. Now, step 3. So the step 3, that is the converting from converting to the resolution steps, or step 3. Then negate the statement to be proved. Whatever the statement that is there, that should be negate. In this statement, we will apply the negation to the conclusion statement, which will be written as. So here, what will be the conclusion statements? John likes peanut. I'm just taking the negation for that. Okay. Not likes John peanut. Means John's does not like peanuts. I'm taking this contradiction and I want to prove. Now, the fourth step of the resolution. What is the fourth step? Draw a resolution graph. Now, in this step, we will solve the problem by resolution tree using the substitution, means with the help of the unification, you are going to draw the resolution graph. Let's see how I'm drawing this resolution graph. See here. Okay. So, first, let me take this the first I am taking the contradiction. John does not like peanuts. So I need to observe. So these are all the quantifiers whatever I get. In this I need to be observed where negation is there. Where the negation is there. John does not like the peanut. Okay. So here see in the first statement likes is there. So negate likes and here the likes is there. So wherever the contradiction statement is there, that statement you need to be checked. So in all these, the contradiction statement observed in the first step itself. So just take that first step. So this is the first step I am taking. Negate food of X or likes John, X. So now here in this, I am going to use a unification method. Substitute in place of X, substitute the peanuts. So now it becomes negate food of peanuts or likes John, peanuts. So here, likes John, peanuts and not likes John, peanuts. So these two will be cancelled. And in place of X, the peanuts will be replaced. So this I got, negate food, peanuts. Now in this quantifiers, drop universal quantifier, the final statements, wherever the contradiction of this food will, that has to be taken. So where is the contradiction here? So the contradiction here is in this statement, food. Okay, so just write this food here, this statement here. Now, in place of Z, apply the peanuts. In place of Z, apply the peanuts. So here the negate food, peanuts, and this is simply food, food of peanuts. Negate food of peanuts and food of peanuts will be cancelled. In place of Z, I substituted peanut. Now, only this statement is remaining. So, bring here. So, now check. The negate eats, wherever the eats is there, that you have to be taken. So here in this case, the eats is there. Here the negate eats and here simply eats is there. Contradiction statement you need to be take. So I taken that statement E. Okay. So in place of Y, I'm substituting Anil. So negate eats Anil, peanuts or killed Y. So this is negate Anil, peanuts and this is simply Anil, peanuts. So both will be cancelled and the remaining item will be the killed Anil. Because in place of Y I substituted Anil. So now killed Anil. Let's see where is the contradiction of killed. So in this statement the contradiction is there. Okay. So killed Anil and negate alive, negate killed I had taken. In place of K I am substituting Anil. So negate killed Anil and killed Anil both will be cancelled. And the remaining one is negate alive K. K in place of K I substituted Anil. Negate alive K. Let's see where is alive Anil. So here it is alive Anil. So write that statement here. Negate and alive both are cancelled. Finally you will get the empty statement. The empty means here the contradiction is proved. Hence, the negation of the conclusion has been proved as a complete contradiction with the set of statements. Okay. So, this is a problem for the, means it's a resolution in FOL. Okay. So, if you don't understand, don't be confused. So, in this video, I just explained with the steps. With the help of the steps, I had taken this problem and solved. Here what I done is just I convert the facts into first order logic. After the second statement, the convert the first order logic into CNF. So to convert the CNF, there are so many steps are there. You need to follow that. And after that, I have to negate the statement which need to be proved. And finally, I draw the resolution graph with the help of unification. So in the next video, I'll take one more example to explain this resolution so that you will clearly understood. Okay, thank you.